Hey, what is going on, party people? Greg Jenkins here from House Monkey Pod. And I wanted to quickly address a question that I have seen pop up in the private Monkey Pod community and also in some of the other Keap communities and Facebook groups out there about the sunsetting of legacy API keys. I know that's a bit of a mouthful. So you might have, if you're a Keap user, you might have seen an email that looked a little like this recently, giving us a heads up about the plans to sunset the legacy API connections, and specifically telling us the number of times or the number of API calls that you might have using this particular method. Now, if you are a brand new Keap user, this probably won't affect you because most of the integrations that you would be using are connecting to Keap through a different methodology. Maybe OAuth or maybe service tokens or service keys or you know, different terminology and different connection types. But there definitely are specific tools or custom-built integrations that might be accessing Keap using this legacy API connection, and that is what is changing. So this is a technical conversation, so I'm going to hand it over to my good friend, Mr. Mark Penny, from MEPI to explain some of the vernacular, some of the terminology about this change and what it means to all of us. Take it away, Mark.
So I just want to do a quick video just to clarify the differences between the API connection methods. So these are all about authorizing the apps to Keap. The API is like a programming language that lets them talk to each applications talk to each other. But the thing that's changing is the way that these apps are being authorized or being given permission to talk to Keap. So what is going away is the legacy key. So this key here, if this has been copied and used inside apps to connect to Keap, it's like a master key to your house. And you're basically handing over the key and saying, go for it. And you can copy the key and give it to anyone you like. So that's one of the main reasons it's going away. It's very hard to track the service account keys and the personal access tokens. So those are the cheaper and easier way for any apps that are using the legacy key to modify to be able to still use a type of key, because these are generated one-off specifically for each app. So you'd create a service account key just for the app that you want to connect, and so for it can't be shared as easily. It's still, you know, a fairly open method, but I think they must be logging things and keeping track of things a bit better with those. If you've got the situation where you've, like with Zapier, where you click on it to connect to Keap, and then it pops up the dialog box saying, you know, log into Keap, and you log in, and then select your app, and you select the app. If you're a partner, you might have 20 million apps. And you scroll down, you find it. That's using OAuth. So that's a much more secure encrypted authorization. It's very hard for hackers to be able to get hold of those keys and be able to use them elsewhere, etc. So that is a method that's widely used now for a lot of API connections. So it's a preferred method. But yeah, you've got to get rid of any apps, or you've got to change or move off apps that are using the legacy connection method and use either the personal access tokens, service account keys, or third-party authorizations using OAuth. If you're using Keap Classic, then it looks like this. It's the same information. It's just presented differently. So hopefully that makes it a little bit clearer. It's really hard to figure out what's using these keys. Yeah, so that's the trick we're all facing at the moment. And that could be like custom little apps connecting to WordPress that people have got built for them by developers, or a partner's got built for by a developer for their client. And then, you know, that person's moved on and the client doesn't realize that this is still relying on that method to connect. Forms or like gravity forms and things, there are different ways of connecting that. Some of those will be using legacy. So yeah, there's a lot of potential for problems to arise when this gets turned off. So yeah, you want to get ahead of it as best you can. Anyway, hope that helps. Cheers.
Okay, so there you have it. Thanks to Mark for that overview of the different connection methods and types. Now, the lingering question that I have and many other people have is, how do I find which tools might be using this, right? If I know I have X number of legacy API calls happening, how do I determine which tools or plugins are dependent on that so that I can resolve them or update them, et cetera? And the truth is I haven't seen a simple answer to that question. I have heard that if you contact Keap support, they can provide you with a list of the types of calls that are being made to your API, but maybe not, you know, where those calls are coming from. So that might be helpful in terms of, you know, the types of calls could lead you to which plugins would be making those calls. But honestly, I haven't found a super straightforward way to get a listing of the different applications or plugins that might be accessing this. So if you want help with this, you're welcome to contact Mark. I happen to know he has done this for a couple of his clients to sort of sleuth out what needs to be updated. But I would recommend just generally spending time with your own integrations, your own tools, and trying to figure out, are they connecting through OAuth or one of the, you know, supported integration types, or are they using that legacy API key, in which case they would need to be, that integration method would need to be updated before they sunset this connection method in, I believe, October of 2024. So a few action items there. Like I said, if you need help with this, reach out to a certified partner or just contact Mark, mepi.com, and he will do his best to help sort you out as well. Thanks for his wisdom and expertise in this video, highlighting what this means, defining terms, etc. And if you have follow-up questions or comments, or you want to add additional thoughts to this, feel free to drop a comment below. That is it for now from me for now. Flop flip that whichever way you want. If you are watching this on YouTube, feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and share it with anyone else who it could serve. Take care.